Today I'm here with a new video, and today it's time for the first impression with one of the new cutie palettes from Nabla, and this is Wild Berry, and this is volume 5, of course, and as all the others, it comes in this plastic little box, and the palette looks like this. I think this looks really cute, and the colors look like this. And it's one in here that's called Alchemy 2.0. And I think they have a single shadow that is the first one. I don't know. But this palette, it's 3 mattes in this and 3 shimmers. It hasn't been that in the other two. But I think I will swatch these, because apparently I swatch these in these videos. I never, like, do that. But yeah, I will swatch this because I don't really know what I want to do today. Okay, so these are the swatches, and it feels like this one is maybe a little bit more of a topper. The other shades look really good, and I don't know if I want to do an all matte look, but it feels like I want to use one of the shimmers as well. And okay, I have to try to remember what I have done. I did 2 pretty dark looks in the other 2 videos. Maybe I should go for a lighter look. But it feels like it's a little bit boring to do like the same look with all the 3 palettes, but also, if that's what I want to do, maybe I should just do it. But I really like these 2 and this one. So maybe I should do something with them. And maybe I should just do what I feel like. If it is pretty similar to one of the looks I've done with the other palettes, I don't care. So I will prime my eyes and then we get started. First, I thought, okay, I know what I want to do, but now I'm not sure. But I think I will take this Venom and put it like in here in my crease. I am a little bit afraid that this is going to be too dark, but here we go. Because first I was thinking about that I wanted to do a lighter look, but now I actually don't know what I want to do. Just something like this, and it's going to look a little bit crazy now and start. I will try to fix it later on. Then I'm going in with Botanic Use, this one, and take it on the rest of my crease. Do you see now it doesn't look that crazy anymore? Okay. I have like no idea what I want to do next. Either to do like a whole shimmer look, or a shimmer lid, or do a complete matte, but maybe a shimmer, and I may know what I want to do. So like this, and then I want to go in with this Bucolic Baby. That's not the word, I think. Nabla, why do you do this to me? Why can't you like name your shades things that I can pronounce, please? So do I want to use this? Yes, I think I do. So I will take this on my lid. And I really wonder which formula this is, because it doesn't feel like, with the Metropolitan palette,
I used a shade all over my lid, and that was more like, I don't know, but this doesn't feel that opaque. Or maybe it does. But it doesn't feel the same. This feels a little bit more like flaky. And I think this would have looked better with a shade under it, but it is what it is right now. I like it, but I don't know if it is a good color to have like on the most of your lid. And I want to go in with it. Alchemy. I can never remember, but I don't know if I want to. I don't know how much it will look without like a sticky base under it or anything, but I think I will try and we will see. It looks a little bit flaky on the brush, but I think this works. Yeah, I think it would have looked so much cooler on like sticky base and like really make it pop. I don't know if it's like a duochrome or what it is. I want to take this over the Venom, the one that I had in my inner crease. I want to go over the other shade a little bit. I actually don't know what I think. I actually don't know what I expected with this look. Okay, I don't actually know what I think about this look. I don't think I like it that much. I think... Okay, now I have shimmer specks all over the palette. I think I will go in with Blackberry and take it out here. Is this not a good idea? I don't know. Just because it feels like I want something. It felt a little bit meh. I don't know if it made it better or if it made it worse. I think I will have it all over my lid. And I'm going with this shimmer and... I don't complain about the shadows, but with my like execution and my placement. But okay, I have had two looks that I loved so much with the other two palettes, and maybe I can't do like three super good looks in a row. Okay, it feels like to take this shade without spraying, without any glitter glue, was not a super good idea because it feels like I have it all over. I like it, but it feels a little bit like messy. I don't like this look. But I will fix my base and then we will see what I'm going to do with the under eyes and see what I feel when like the whole look is complete. Sometimes it feels like without face makeup, some looks just don't look good. So I will fix my base and then I come back and we will see if this gets any better. So yeah. Okay, so for my under eyes, I think I just want to go in with this one that I had in my crease and just smudge it on my eye.
And then I just dip the brush. Then I just take the brush a little bit in this shade I cannot pronounce and put a little bit of shimmer in here. Yeah, it feels a little bit better with a look, but I'm not like super satisfied with it, if I'm going to be honest. I think it feels like it's too much and it's everything and nothing, and I don't like that. But I will put on some mascara and something on my lips, and hopefully it will feel a little bit better. Okay, so this is the finished look. For my waterline, I used Boots from ColourPop, and on my lips I used a lipstick in Gold Digger. And what do I think about this cutie palette? I think it's equally good as the others, and I like the look a little bit more now, but if I am going to do one more look with this, I am not going to do this look. I used all the colors except for this one, and it feels like it's everything and nothing in the same look, and I am not a fan. But the colors were easy to work with, and yeah. It feels like I'm repeating myself, but maybe not everybody's watching all of the free videos with these cutie palettes, but I really like it. I think it's a good palette. I thought that this was going to be my favorite, but I don't think it is. I actually don't know. Maybe the Metropolitan or maybe the Platinum. I don't know, but not this one. And this I thought was going to be my favorite, but it is a really, really nice palette. And I thinking about doing a palette bingo with all of the cutie palettes. Well, the 5 of them, and see, it feels like it can be really fun and colorful, or really, really meh. But yeah, I like this. And as I have said in the other 2 videos, if you want to buy a cutie palette, I can recommend them all. Just buy the one that you want the color story from. I think this is the one that is not as neutral as the others. You can do a neutral look with this, but I don't think it's like that easy to do a neutral look. So yeah, I am just going to end this here. I really hope that you like this video, and I will leave all of the other cutie palettes up in the card. And did you buy any of these cutie palettes, or do you have one of the 2 first ones they released? Please let me know. So yeah, I really hope you like this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, so don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye!